Hello everyone, here we are reacting to another Dimash video.
What do we have today?
Hello, today is Cross Endless Dimensions Day from the Slavic Bazaar 2021. So this is from the same concert that we saw last time where it was like, Love is Like a Dream. So we are going to continue.
Oh, so this is the new one. This is from this year.
2021. Yes, there's three performances. One is Across Endless Dimensions, Be With Me, and this one. So.
Okay.
Yeah, we've already heard this like kind of recently, but we wanted to do another one because you guys requested the new stuff.
We've heard this song, but not this particular.
Yes. So this is going to sound different. Yeah.
Great.
Let's get right into it.
Дамы и господа, встречайте заслуженный деятель Казахстана. Певец,
The honored worker. Wow, I want to be introduced like that.
24-го международного конкурса исполнителя эстрадной песни «Витебск 2015» Димаш Кудайберген, Казахстан!
Oh, the all whites.
A lot of live instruments.
Oh yeah.
Some horns I heard.
I think you heard right. Again, this is one of my favorite ones just because I said in the other one it's like very Muse sounding song,
yeah,
right? And just, you know, I relate to Across Endless Dimensions.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Riding Across Endless Dimensions?
Yeah, you know, our band is called the Emerald Riders. But again, it's like Dimash is just so in control. You can even tell, like, the current ones, his confidence is not suffered from the time off. You can tell he's only become more and more in control, and he's just so comfortable up on stage as we are on this couch.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Clutching the pillow of desire.
I love the pillow of desire. Mm-hmm. That part gave me very Disney Prince energy.
Yeah, you know, I think his whole thing is very Disney Prince right now.
Yeah, I'm getting Disney Prince.
I gotta say, you look like a Disney princess today, by the way.
Like,
what the heck? What the actual heck?
It's the discount code. But I was just saying his voice just sounds like so on that it sounds like it's fake auto-tune. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But we all know it's not. But like, it was so like right on that it feels like legit like Disney Prince energy.
Yeah, he even does even the hair this time, Disney Prince.
Prince Eric?
White trench coat? I don't know. I guess I've never seen a white trench coat before. This is my first time ever seeing a white trench coat.
Maybe it just doesn't need to be.
Because where are you going to wear a white trench coat?
To your own show.
Like if it's raining, it's like, well, now it's ruined.
Yeah.
You know?
The practicality isn't really there.
Yeah. But he looks great. So.
Oh, breathy.
I like that. I like the end of that, the core of my life thing. They have the delay just on the last part. So the way that you do this is you actually have somebody kind of controlling at the front of house or wherever they're mixing everything, and they can put specific effects on for certain parts of the song.
Sounds a little stressful. I guess it's all timed, right?
You can time it. So there's a couple ways you can actually build a track in a software thing, so it'll activate that effect during this part of the song, which it sounds like at least part of the percussion is to like a track, right, that everybody else is playing to keep in time. Or there's just some dude back there that's just like hitting delay and taking it off. A couple different ways you can do it.
But stressful though.
Yeah, it's but you know what?
What if there's like a lag time?
Performing at the highest stakes. Performing at the highest stakes is a stressful gig.
Also, I really love Dimash's necklace, I would like to say.
You like the necklace?
Yeah.
Another bold move, going shirtless under a trench coat. See,
he does that a lot. He does the shirtless thing under things a lot.
And again, I go shirtless with the trench coat on, and people start calling the cops. Dimash goes shirtless with a trench coat, and it's like, oh, cool, the pinnacle of fashion. How fair is that?
Probably all the flowers.
Yeah, exactly.
I heard it more. If you hear it, there's life. Live.
Yeah, do it one more time. Let's
yeah, we
heard
it.
I know, love it when the end screens just kind of interrupt the whole thing.
I know. Well, anyways, I think one thing we should talk about, okay, like, I feel like this song is one of my favorites, actually.
Yeah? Okay, why is that?
I don't know, I feel like it's just interesting.
Sounds great. The arrangement's very cool. It's very kind of like, almost like rock. That's why, like I said, it reminds me of Muse. There's guitar stuff in there. You can tell that there are guitar harmonies in there, so there's multiple guitars. Now, it could be one guitar with a harmony pedal going on. Or it could be two guitars playing, because you can hear single notes being played on a guitar. And again, so a guitar has six strings, you could potentially play six notes at the same time. But what I was hearing harmonically, which is very like rock and roll style, single notes on the guitar doubled up with a harmony note on a separate guitar, right? And you can play them in like fifths. Like, so if one guitar is playing like a C note, the other one's playing like a G note, and then together they have a very signature sound that you can hear in this. Again, it might not be two guitars, it could be one guitar player with a pedal, but it definitely sounded like two guitars.
I mean, wouldn't be that surprised if it was two guitars. There are like
a lot of people back there.
Like, you know? Oh, we only could get one guitar player, like, doesn't seem like that's the case. But I feel like even the track, I feel like, builds upon itself. Like, even when it's, like, when we get into the bigger parts, I feel like there's faster notes or, like,
totally.
Eighth notes or something that kind of make it seem more.
Yeah, and the strings aren't overpowering. You know, they're there, but I think the core of it is, like, a rock track.
Yes. You know? I feel like the strings are just helping
move
the song along.
Oh, for sure. They've got the tried and true Phil Collins drum fill.
Yeah, like that whole part.
Yeah, so that's how you know it's classic rock inspired. Another banger from our guy.
You should finish the last part again.
Okay, sure.
Oh.
Wow. He's done it again. He's simply done it again.
He's simply done it again. What can we say?
What more is there to say?
Nothing.
Other than you two could look like a Disney princess with these pants.
Harem pants, 10% off. We spa, links below. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this performance is just great. Always great.
Yeah, production's great, on point. I think something they're doing on stage more is they're having a handheld camera person circling him, which is how we get these direct eye contact things. That
how we get everyone's new background.
That's it, yeah. Yeah, exactly. So usually you can't see that camera person because you'll notice that when they do those kind of like 360 shots, they don't pan to a wide one. Usually they'll pan to a close-up next because they got to have the cameraman get off the stage.
Oh, I've always wondered how they do that. They have to get them out? That's
yeah.
how they do it?
Yeah, there's usually one person with like, you know, like either like a monopod or a rig or something to hold the camera straight. And like if you're Dimash and I'm the guy, I just circle around you.
And then
right?
book it.
And then run off stage so you're not in the wide shot. But obviously it doesn't. Doesn't bother Dimash. I mean, I guess you could just fly a drone around his head if you really wanted to.
That'd be genius.
That could be a little annoying.
I mean, I'm pretty sure his pitch would not even change.
If anything, he would set the pitch for the drone to whirl at. And then all the drones
in the world
would vibrate at the same time.
Part of the orchestra.
To that pitch. Amazing. He's done it again.
So yeah, thank you so much. Feel free to let us know what we should react to next, and we'll see you in the next Dimash reaction.